Hi, welcome to another edition of Options and Oswald, Delta Dollars Part 3. Today we're going to discuss how we can use Delta Dollars to put on a Delta neutral relative value trade using optionality.
You want to calculate the hedge ratio in a relative value trade using Delta Dollars to figure out how to put us in a Delta neutral position. If you are trading two assets against each other, looking for mean reversion, instead of doing a very popular pairs trade, going long one asset and short another asset, sort of a long short, we can use optionality, which is a better methodology. Depending on how the trade is set up, you can reduce or eliminate many of the problems associated with pairs trading using the underlying asset, as well as improve your hit ratio.
And we say there's going to be mean reversion, and then we're just going to play that mean reversion by shorting the overvalued and being long the undervalued. It's a concept that's pretty common. What's not used a lot is optionality. If it is used, it's used incorrectly.
When you find two highly correlated assets that have diverged, let's say 1.5 to 2 Z scores or more from their regression, you basically want to set up for a mean reversion. That's the idea. So let's start by looking at a 1 month rolling Z-score matrix on a list of correlated assets. We have an asset, let's say HYG, the high yield bond ETF, is trading 1.9 Z-scores above its regression line compared to the S&P 500. So how can we trade that? How can we find edge in that situation?
How do we calculate and put on a trade, a delta neutral trade, that is just going to play the relative mean reversion?
Well, here's where Delta Dollars comes in. What we want to do is we want to calculate the Delta Dollars in the S&P 500 against, which in this case is HYG, and we want to calculate how we can put the trade on into a delta neutral position using optionality. The first thing that we're going to do is we're going to decide what delta of SPY we're going to use on one side of the pairs trade. Choose your delta and then calculate your notional exposure. In other words, multiply your delta times the underlying price to give you your delta dollar position of your SPY, which we talked about in Delta Dollars Part 1 and Part 2. Then calculate our cross asset weighting of our dependent variable, in this case HYG. We're going to choose a delta that we feel comfortable with. We're going to calculate the notional exposure. But as we talked about in Delta Dollars Part 2, we've got to multiply the delta dollar position of HYG times the beta to give us an adjusted delta dollar position. So once we calculate the beta of HYG to SPY, let's say over the last year, we have all the information to put on a delta neutral cross asset trade, and then it just becomes arithmetic. So for this example, I'm just gonna simply go back in time, and I just randomly picked a date, March 17th, 2016. Our heat map, or our Z-score chart, was saying that HYG is trading 1.9 Z-scores above SPY. So essentially we're saying the movement in HYG has outperformed based on the historical regression compared to SPY. It's trading essentially 1.9 standard deviation above where historically should be trading. So that means that HYG is relatively overvalued or SPY is relatively undervalued.
So the bottom line is we can say that HYG is overvalued with respect to how it's traded against SPY on its regression. That means either HYG is going to move towards SPY or SPY is going to move towards HYG.
Now it's just arithmetic. We plug and play. We say, okay, we have 50 deltas of SPY times price gives us 10,232 delta dollars. Divide that by what? By a 28 delta HYG position times price times the beta, which gives us 783 delta dollars. We come up with 13.06 contracts of HYG. What that means in English, For every 150 Delta contract of SPY I execute, I should execute 13, 28 Delta contracts of HYG, which will put us, based on historical regression, into a Delta neutral position.
What I want to do is I want to put on a trade that will be a credit or at least very low carry cost trade.
There's many ways I could trade a relative value trade using optionality. For this short video, what I'm going to do is I'm going to sell 13 calls on HYG at right out of 28 Delta, about 30 days, which would bring in a credit of $689. As you can see from the P&L, the trade has 36 days to expiry. The trade brings in $680 in credit because we're selling 13 calls. And we're doing it roughly at a 28. The closest I can get to a 28 Delta is 31.85, as you can see from the screen. Now, to put the trade in a Delta neutral position, I'm going to buy one call on SPY, 50 Delta, and that's going to cost me $308.50. It has the same date to expiry, 36 days, only the Delta I'm trading is not exactly 50. The closest I can get is 51.95, which is just off the money. As you can see, it's a debit of 308.50. The SPY is trading at 204.64. So the combination of buying one call on SPY at 50 Delta and selling 13 calls on HYG at a 28 Delta, if I execute both trades at the same time, is actually going to result in a credit of $380.50. But believe it or not, this trade, based on its historical regression and taking beta into account, is Delta neutral. What we're really just trying to trade here is mean reversion. So let's move forward in time and see how we did. So we take off the trade a day before expiry. The long call on SPY, one day to expiry, made a profit of $279.50. The short calls on HYG, one tail day to expiry, made a profit of $162.50. And we can see that HYG has moved up. It's moved up about $1. The SPY trade actually moved up more than HYG moved up. That's exactly what we had hoped for, that the spread between HYG, which was way out of its regression line from SPY, was overstretched. So that means hopefully the spread comes in.
If the market goes up, is SPY moving up more than HYG? And if the market moves down, is HYG losing more than SPY? I win on both scenarios, as well as win if the market is flat. Now, I also could win HYG move more than SPY because I'm off the money. As long as it doesn't go considerably higher, then I'll take a loss on that one side of the trade. Now, in Delta Dollars Part 4, what we're going to get into is thinking about different setups and thinking about why you strike your optionality, where you strike your optionality to give you the most edge. Thank you for listening. Oswald has had a tough day, but his knowledge is vast and wide, and he is my mentor. He is my inspiration, and he's taught me everything I know about options. So thank you, Oswald. Pretty chill today, pretty chill. And in fact, we should all be chill because life should be chill. But anyway, thanks for listening for another edition to Options and Oswald.